Good afternoon, guys. It's the next one of my Traxxas Rustler 4x4 VXL upgrades, and this one should be fairly obvious to you because they aren't on the car anymore, and that is the shock absorbers. You'll also notice it's got the new sway bars fitted front and rear, steel CVD drive shafts, and a castle setup on there. Most of the point, Richie, what are you doing about the shocks? Well, following a bit of asking around on the Facebook group on the Traxxas Rustler 4x4, people advised me to get the GTR shocks. Now, the shocks don't come with springs.
Just note, you will need to buy new springs. The existing ones will not fit.
It does come a little bottle of shock oil with each one. You'll see four here, but you buy them in twos. But the front ones are the long GTR shocks. The rear ones are the XX long or extra long shocks. Now you think that's all you're getting for your money, your two shocks, your shock oil, and you're just about to throw this piece of packaging away. Whoa, don't do that, Richie boy, because tucked away in the back here is a little packet with the top of the shock oil bottle and two screws. So make sure you don't chuck that away, guys. So what's there to love about the Traxxas GTR shocks compared to the stock ones? Well, the first and most obvious thing is not the internals, but the externals. These are fully adjustable, fully threaded up and down on there. There's no preload spacer to put in there. You can vary the tension on the spring up and down using this threaded bars compared to the stock ones, which you put the preloaded spacer in on there. A little bit fiddly to use if you've ever tried to adjust those. I believe the action on these should also be much smoother, and they're supposed to leak less than the equivalent Proline shocks are for less money. So that's why I've gone with you guys from the Facebook Traxxas Rustler 4x4 group recommendations. Now, there isn't anything hugely complicated about fitting shocks, as you've simply got one screw in the top, one screw in the bottom. The key thing is to make sure that you put them in the same holes you take them out of. Like my top one is in the middle position there. At the front, however, I'm on the third from the outer position on there, which is the one second. This setting Traxxas recommend for fast road usage, so just make sure you put them back in the same place.
Now, just a minor issue when it comes to the shocks. Come on, Traxxas. Only two screws, two shock absorbers, 2x2, that's four screws needed, guys. So don't throw your existing ones away, because you're gonna need them.
Of note, to add to that confusion, the two screws the shocks come with are longer than all of the existing ones. So does that mean I'm all right to use two of these for, say, the bottom ones, or do I need to get two more long ones to fit top and bottom?
Okay, guys, well, when it comes to putting the shock oil in, things should be fairly simplistic. Just ensure you screw this down enough to give yourself a nice clear gap in order to grab hold of the top of the shock fin. People will probably tell me I'm doing this the wrong way, but it works for me. And then I'm just gonna turn that round. Tell me that's loose enough for me to do it by hand. And there we are, one shock absorber all ready to put the shock oil in.
Okay, guys, well, the Traxxas shocks come with a little bottle of oil with it. It doesn't specify the weight on there, so that's not an awful lot of help.
However, with a bit of searching around, I found quite a few people recommending 50 weight for the rack. One guy said, kept increasing the weight of the oil in the back until the bottom end stopped slapping on the floor. That's exactly the kind of method of thinking that I like. I also recommend 35 weight in the front, not only 35 weight, but I've got 40, so I'm going to have 50 in the rear, 40 in the front. Any comments or questions, or yeah, you've got an opinion on this, then please put it in the comment section below the video.
Okay, well, I've got my first shock topped up with oil, got the air out of it, so I'm gonna screw the top on and it's ready to go.
And for tightening that shock up, I'm gonna use exactly the same method I did for undoing it. On the top in the pliers, very gently turn around with the driver through the top until that's finger tight.
That's my first shock absorber, fill the door, time to do the other three and fit the springs on.
The one thing I would say is when you are doing them, do them in pairs, front and back. Don't leave them all on the bench and pick them up by accident and put the wrong way of shock oil in the wrong shock absorber.
Well, fitting new shocks and springs may seem a simple job to people. You've just got the two screws, obviously, there to attach it onto the car. But when it comes to fitting new springs, as an example, you need to remove this part from the end, otherwise you're wondering how the heck to fit the new spring on there. Well, guys, well, I've got all four shocks ready to go, thinking I'm just about there. There is one slight problem. It would appear the GTR shocks are slightly wider than the existing ones, so I think I'm gonna need GTR springs, as these will not fit, nor will they fit on the end cap on there. It's just marginally too wide. No amount of wiggling and jiggling is gonna get that to sit perfectly well. So
I was just about calling that, as the stock springs won't fit on my new GTR shocks. And if you look at these as well, the rear spring, or the XX long one, is substantially different in size. So I'm gonna require two new sizes of, so I'm definitely gonna require new springs for the car. But then that set me thinking, Rich, you've just sold your eRevo 2.0, which also has GTR shocks on there. Now, these things are much, much stiffer than the Russell ones, but I've got even the Russell GTR ones, which is interesting, as these are exactly the same size as the front ones for the Russell GTR. So I've got my gold ones and my tan ones off of my eRevo 2.0, so that's certainly got my front shocks at. So as a minimum, I've got something there to try out on the front of the car. Just need to get long ones to go on the rear.
Okay, well, I've got my new GTR springs. The ones on the left here are the pink rate ones, which are the same rate as the existing ones that were on the back there. It's all pink tab on there. And these ones on the right are the blue rate, which is the same stiffness as the existing front ones were, with a little blue tab on there. But I need the extra long ones, and I needed them to be the GT, so I couldn't just reuse these. And besides which, these aren't thick enough. So on with these. So I'm going to try the blue ones to start with, as I want the rear end a little bit firmer.
Well, that's my GTR shock mod for the Traxxas Rosso 4x4 complete. At the front, I've fitted the eRevo. I set a pair of my older eRevo springs on it. They are not actually too stiff on air, but because they're a little bit stiffer than the stock Rustler ones, I've kept the tension eased right off on the shock on there, and we will see how we get on with those. Likewise on the back, got the blue springs on there. Will they be stiff enough? Will they be too stiff? Anyway, I've got a pair of the pink springs to try on the rear, should the blue ones prove too stiff. Now the next step is obviously testing the thing outdoors, seeing how it handles, and playing around with those spring tensions and the shock weight oils. So if you don't want to miss that test, then please do subscribe if you've not done so already. Plenty more videos on the mods to this car coming very shortly.
You liked this video? If you did, please click on the circle image to subscribe. And if you hit subscribe, then don't forget to hit that little notifications bell next to it.